डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 4, द पीपल ऑफ द केव। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द रीडिंग, आफ्टर रीडिंग दिस यूनिट यू विल बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन ग्लोबल डायमेंशंस ऑफ इस्लाम एंड इट्स प्रेजेंस अक्रॉस द ग्लोब ग्लोबल लैंग्वेजेस। नंबर 2, आइडेंटिफाई एंड अप्रिशिएट डाइवर्सिटी एंड इक्वालिटी ऑफ पीपल फ्रॉम अक्रॉस द रिलीजन्स and countries. Explain that literature has multi-linguistic background. Identify anecdote and poem as different types of text in written language. Differentiate and use different types of nouns, pronouns, verbs and adjectives. Then write a short paragraph in a creative way. Enhance fluency of expression through quotations, idioms, speech acts, and fun reading. All these are the parts of exercise. Now we come to these points one by one. Number 1, explain global dimensions of Islam and its presence across the global languages. Now, what is the meaning of this statement? Global dimension of Islam. Islam is a universal religion. And it was present even before the birth of the Holy Prophet. Now, how it was present before that? This is the question. When the people came, the man came on this earth, then some people, they never worshipped idols. And they just have a concept of oneness of Allah. And these people, they were called as Muslims in the book that you are reading. So the people who accepted oneness of Allah, these people were called as Muslims even before Islam. So it's a global dimension. And these kinds of people, they were present all over the world even before the birth of the Holy Prophet. Even when the Islam, that religion that we are following, that came in this world. Now, next is identify and appreciate diversity and equality of people from across the religions and countries. The people who are living on this planet Earth, they have different cultures, they have different languages, and they follow different kinds of ethics, they follow different kinds of things, they live differently, but at the same time, there are certain things which are common in different religions as well as among the human beings that are living across the globe. For example, all the people, they have some set examples of ethics that is followed all over the world. Similarly, the people, they follow different religions, but there are some commonalities also across the globe among different religions. So there are also diversity, means there are different type of people, different cultures, different religions, different languages, but at the same time there are some similarities also among the people who are living across the globe in different countries of the world. So we'll talk about different languages that are spoken all over the world in this chapter also. Now explain that literature has multilinguistic background. Means multilinguistic means having different languages. There are so many different languages that are spoken all over the world, and the languages that are also the presentation of the culture of a country, and they are also related with the literature. Literature is actually refined kind of language, the image of a society. So all these things are interconnected with each other. You can't separate linguistics and literature. The languages that are connected with the literature. Then we have identify anecdote. Anecdote means a short amusing story, as this one that is also there in your book. And then a poem, you already know that is a certain rhythm that is there, certain musicality that is there, certain thought that is there in a poem. And poem is obviously very much different from prose. We have already talked about the difference between prose and poetry in the first chapter. And these are very different kinds of text. Obviously, in this unit, there is an anecdote, there is an incident, there is a story of the people of the cave, and at the same time there is a poem also that is included in this unit. Then differentiate and use different types of nouns, pronouns, verbs and adjectives, as is there in the other chapters also, different items of grammar that are also there, that are also included in this unit. Then obviously the creative writing, a paragraph in a creative way that you will write. Then how to enhance the fluency of expression by different means, for example, by fun reading, by the use of quotations, by the use of idioms, by the dialogues. All these things are also there in this unit. This was a short introduction of the unit. Then we come to the pre-reading exercise. Have you read or heard any story from the Noble Quran? Share with your class. Yes, you might have read about different stories that are there in Quran. There are certain stories that are there in Quran. These are called as Qasasul Quran. You might have read about that. Then we come to the pre-reading exercise. That is, have you read or heard any story from the Noble Quran? Share with your class. Yes, there are certain stories that are there in Quran. This is called Qasasul Quran. For example, the story of Adam and Eve, Hazrat Adam and Hawa. And similarly, the story of Moses and the story of the Joseph. All these are in Quran. Similarly, the story of the people of Cave, that is called Ashabe Kahf. There is also a surah in Quran that is called Surah Kahf, in which the story of these people that is written. The same kind of stories are also there in Bible and the other holy books also. So the Christians, the Jews, they are also aware of these stories because that is also there in their holy books. Originally, these stories were there in Bible and the other holy books also, but there are some minute differences that are there in the stories that are being told in these books and in the Holy Quran. Obviously, we as Muslims, we believe whatever is there in Quran. And how the story is presented in Quran, we all believe in that as a Muslim. Then we come to the next, that is, the Noble Quran was revealed in Arabic language. Do you know what were the languages of the other holy books? Other holy books, most of them, they were revealed in Hebrew language. And a specific kind of language that is not spoken by anyone nowadays in the world. So, these languages, these are the dead languages. These were translated in so many other languages of the world. And most of the people now, they read these books in translated form, not in original form. But this is also, you can say, a miracle of Quran that was revealed in Arabic. That is a very much living languages. There are so many people in the world who speak Arabic as their national language as well as their mother tongue. And Arabic is also the language of the United Nations. So many people, they speak this language even today. So it is not difficult for us to understand Quran in its original form, in its original language. We don't need to translate it. And so, although it is translated in different languages, but we can also understand that in its original form, that is in Arabic. So that is also a miracle of Quran. Otherwise, the other holy books, they were revealed in Hebrew, and nobody speaks Hebrew nowadays. Nobody knows about Hebrew, exact meanings of Hebrew, and there are so many other changings also that has been done in these languages, in these books. That is why the only authentic book that is present in the world today, that is the Holy Quran. So the anecdote that is there in this book, that is also from the Holy Quran. The things that are there in your book, that is all from the Holy Quran. It means it is all authentic. It is not just a story. It is an authentic thing that has been chosen from the Holy Quran. So I think that's enough for today's. Thank you very much.